Welcome again to City Scene TV. So as we noted at the top of the show, we're going to be meeting now with Peter Godinez, who is going to discuss career path assistance for students, including an e-learning program. And Peter has a day job, but he's been working for Xerox for many years and engages a lot in community involvement, but he's also very passionate about career options for our youth. So thank you for joining us, Peter.
It's such a pleasure, Joe, to be here. You just don't know.
That's great.
Well, welcome. So Peter, tell us, why is it that you're so passionate about careers here in our community?
That's a really good question. So I want to start off by saying myself going through a career path. You said I've been around a long time. I also raised two successful children, a son and a daughter, who are in careers. And as I see the youth in our community now, I see them using cell phones. They like the fashion. They like the cars. And guess what? They got to make money to afford those things.
That's right.
And they can't always live off their parents, uncles, and all that stuff. So that really kind of ignites my passion for it. And we have at Xerox, you have a lot of things, a crisis of opportunity before us. Mm-hmm. So given that, that's why I'm just so passionate about, especially this community.
That's okay. Good. So when you see those high school students, you know, what is it that you can give them to help them create some career opportunities for themselves?
You know, it's a good question. Every one of them is completely different. They come from different profiles, financial backgrounds, skills, talents. So I guess I offer them just portals and an ability to, hey, let's think through this. Mm-hmm. Let's strategize as to what we want to do and minimize on the mistakes, if I could say that, that potentially all of us have made in regards to investing in an education. And you realize an education really has to do with, okay, finding a purpose in life, but I just can't get away. My mortgage just doesn't seem to go away. It just always is there. So the importance of making a living. So I think what I can provide is a strategy and different opportunities, both old and new, because things are changing.
Sure, absolutely. So it appears that collaboration with Xerox provides instruction on cutting-edge software. It also addresses packaging, signage, building materials, and other uses. Has there been any inroads with our schools here in Camarillo and elsewhere in Camarillo's outlying community in Ventura County with Xerox in collaboration?
I think the opportunity is growing because we have, again, when you have a place that this is where actually Kinko's actually started. Paul Orfila still lives in this area, in Ventura County. And although it's not Kinko's anymore, it's FedEx,
right.
You know, things change. I mean, all the infrastructure is there. And to your point, one of the case studies is La Vista and La Sierra High School down in Fullerton, is what you're talking about. And I'd like to address that this is a location where students are getting things from left to right in terms of the instruction, the curriculum, hands-on experience. They learn about interactive skills. They learn how to interview. They get introductions to business leaders.
Wow.
And so they start off early. And the nice thing about this high school, it's a continuation high school. It's so-called the students who are not in the mainstream of the district.
Right.
And it's kind of like, again, I date myself, the bad news bears, you know.
Sure.
It's like these are the ones who really supposedly didn't have a chance. They weren't going to go to college and they don't have the money for it, and they just may make a big difference in this area. And that's in Southern California, so that's the case study that I'm actually working with.
That's good. That sounds great.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's talk a little bit more about college.
Sure.
There's information from your program that indicates that only 27% of college students who graduate end up in a job or a career related to their major.
Right.
And, you know, what's some of the connections with your program and how we're addressing this issue?
Sure. Whenever I see percentages, so you know, I just say, well, that's what the truth is. When I see percentages like 27%, I'm a little bit more like, come on, seriously?
Right.
And, you know, it's to the point, if you've ever been to college, you realize everybody is different. I had a chance because I could run fast. That's why I thought you go to college, you know?
Correct.
And it's just like, well, what am I doing? I might as well pick a major. And so everybody's path is different. So I think if you go to school to become a doctor or an accountant, or you have, you know, scientific things and you go that's the 27%, but I think a bigger majority of students go there, and possibly they're still kind of figuring it out. Mm-hmm. And the big thing I'm big into, it's let's not overspend. Because it's like an investment. When you're a student, you invest money. I don't have a graph, but you know, you invest money. You know, you're not making any money. You have to live at home, still the expenses, you got to eat. But then sooner or later, all of a sudden, money has to kick in. It's just like starting a business.
Sure.
You put money into the business, but sooner or later, you got to have revenues coming in. So to the point that 27%, I wanted to use it as kind of a shock value. Like, no way, no stinking way.
Right.
Right.
Because everybody's got a different path.
Right.
You know, I've been able to run fast, but I wasn't like the smartest student. I had to really work hard to get a C minus, you know, and then you realize that hard work and more your personality, your drive, who you hang around actually plays a big part of that.
Absolutely.
So the 27%, I didn't quote that. I just pulled that from the internet, and that's what it says. What percentage of students actually graduate in their major?
Right. Well, are you part of the 27%,
you know,
or is your major in something different?
I mean, this story is not over yet, though. That's the whole thing. It's, you know, went to school on a scholarship with Decathlon. My dad says, hey, you should do business. I thought marketing, because I know your background's marketing. Oh, marketing, you know?
Uh-huh.
And then somebody sticks me in a sales position. They go, I don't want to push anybody to sell anything.
Right.
So it's like it changed.
Sure, absolutely.
It changed. And, you know, the scholarship paid for my education. You know, what I don't like is when a student has to take money that possibly is their grandparents and it's their life savings, or even worse, they get into debt.
Yeah, student loans.
And
yeah,
I don't even know
tough.
The percentage of students who are in debt, and it's unforgivable debt. And it, maybe some people pay it off when they're late 30s and 40s, but that's something I hope
that's
what
tough.
I can contribute to students. Let's not go there.
Sure. Well, we have some photographs that we would like to show our audience. If you could please outline them for us, Peter.
I hope they're none of my college, but no, I'm just kidding. Go ahead. And that's a logo of the company. The company has transitioned over the years, but this is where I started with Kinko's, but I've always been with Xerox since 1981. The program that is down in Orange County, Fullerton, is actually the Xerox Digital Career Pathway Program. And there's an acronym, so we call it the XDCPP. So that's actually what it is. And again, this is just a stock picture of students, but you know, when I look at this, I've encouraged, so there's some empowered women in there, and if you know me, I have a daughter. I just really think that the ladies, if I could put it that way, are gonna make a big difference in our culture.
Sure.
So I'm happy about, this is a little bit small, but it just talks about, this is the different traditions of traditional education, people who maybe took time off. So, you know, we have such a great diversity in our culture of people who are just not coming from high school right into college and career. We have people who went in the military, some people who work part-time and got into that. But there's a lot of successful people in this area who didn't get a degree, but they really worked hard. If anybody knows the name Sam Hishmay, he owns Domino's Pizza.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's probably one of the more wealthy people in this world, but he didn't go to college and all that, but he works hard. So
yeah, absolutely.
That's what I'd say about this one. You know, I said that the top best paying jobs, definitely it's going to take some education. You know, if you want to be a doctor, you know, for Chantel and myself, you know, if you can get into sales and real estate and you get a good clientele, you know, you can make a lot of money if you know how to work with people. There's just money on that, but it doesn't really take, and I know you're a gaucho, and I make sure that counted, okay? But, you know, it's just like these jobs take a lot of specific education. The software architect, you know, the pharmacy, the software, and you know, I would say unfortunately in this area, not a lot of those jobs are actually in this community.
Okay. Yeah, and on that note,
sure.
Not everyone goes to college, and there are a lot of learning opportunities
yes.
in life experience.
Yes.
And what does your program do to help those who are maybe not looking to go the route of getting a college degree?
Oh, wow. You know, it's just, I got to watch how I say that, because sometimes the parents might have a dream that they're their child has something, so I want to be careful. But, you know, just trying to find out, and I said that in my conclusion, what the person's personality, what their temperaments. Mm-hmm. I was terrible at math, but, you know, I got through it. So I wasn't going to be somebody, you got to be really good in math with certain fields, things like that. But for students who don't want to go that route, you know, it's trying to always get education, so community college is a really important one. But you're working part-time,
right,
or full-time. There's a lot of people who work full-time and go to college. So I think as long as you're making a living, and not all of us have the ability to have somebody to fund us for a period of time, mm-hmm. you know, living at home.
Sure.
Sometimes you have to join resources with your friends and make things happen.
Right.
But see, that's just one kind of profile.
Yeah.
So for the person who does not want to go to college,
mm-hmm.
I say keep on educating yourself. You know, find a mentor, those types of things. Life experience is what it's going about. So, but I don't believe somebody should try to be going to, let's just call it, you didn't go to USC. That's an expensive place to go.
Sure.
And so not everybody has the funds to do that.
Right.
So anyway.
So before we get wrapped up,
sure.
You have one more photo if you want to outline that.
You know, besides just the graphics, this looks like, this is 3D. We actually have the technology, and I've worked with this, where we can actually produce different parts of
wow.
the human body. And I've done interviews at of Oxnard College, and we have students who are actually working with human tissues that actually use in a 3D printer.
Remarkable.
Is that not a career? I mean, my goodness, from internal organs to this
remarkable.
And that. Chantel's going like, you're so gross.
Where can students and parents get more information?
You know, on this one, you can call me. We can go down and take a VIP tour of the high schools. There's just so much info.
What's the number, but before we wrap up?
You know what? How about if I give you, if you go to the
SoCal-Xerox.com, okay.
You can find all the information. You can see this case study. You can get a hold
That's
of me.
That's great, Peter. Thank
We're
you so much.
Thank you, Peter. And thank you for appearing on City Scene TV. And